The most popular group in Denver during the mid-1960s was the Moonrakers, with four singles hitting the local charts on KIMN radio, the biggest being You'll Come Back. But Joel Brandis, Denny Flanagan, Bob McVitie, Bob Weber, and Wieter Van Dorn couldn't break out nationally. After several membership changes, the Moonrakers returned in 1969 with the Christian rock album Together With Him. The drummer on half the songs was Jerry Corbetta, who as a teenager had played keyboards in The Half Dozen and The Brambles. Corbetta returned to keyboards, and as the decade was waning, the cream of Denver bands came together as Chocolate Hair.
And I said to Bob Weber in California, I want to go back to Denver and start a super band. Remember that?
Absolutely.
We came back to Denver, and that was the days when they used to have super bands, all the best musicians could play. And so he chose Bob Raymond, who was with the band The Soul Survivors with Gene Chalk. And then I chose a guy named Myron Pollock, who stayed in the band for a while.
Playing clubs and honing their chops, Chocolate Hair transformed into a tight unit, playing a mix of rock, R&B, and jazz licks.
If you say hair, tonight is half price night at Kelker Junction, where we say,
kick out the jams, brothers and sisters!
Tonight is half price night at Kelker Junction, and the band is Chocolate Hair.
It was an interesting time, trying to show up at class at 8 o'clock in the morning after being in a bar playing till 1 o'clock in the morning.
We did it.
Yeah, we're better for it.
Chocolate Hair recorded demos with producer Frank Slay that got them signed to Liberty Records. The 7-song demo became the basis for their debut LP, but only after a new drummer, Bob McVitie, came on board to record the last song for the album, Green-Eyed Lady.
Green-eyed lady, lovely lady.
And I was of the opinion that we needed one more song. And my producer said, well, you know, don't. They like the album like it is. And I pushed him and pushed him and came out with the song that became Green-Eyed Lady with the melody with different words. And he said, well, I like that. He said, but the words aren't good. And at that point, my girlfriend at the time, Kathy Peacock, walked in the room in the studio and she had green eyes. And somebody said, here comes the Green-Eyed Lady, and that kind of fit with my Be My Baby. And so I went downstairs with John Phillips and David Reardon, and we wrote the words on a taco bag from Los Arcos. We were eating tacos and wrote the words, and I went upstairs and sang it off of the taco bag. But when it came to singing, Bobby Darin was the guy that I really said, that's it. So I wasn't really a singer, but I became one in 6 minutes.
The band scored a big national hit. Green-Eyed Lady peaked at number 3 in October 1970, pushing the album to number 24 as well.
A lot of us thought that the best thing you could do was be in a very, very large and impressive studio where very important people had recorded. Really, the most important thing is to have a great engineer and have great miking on the instruments. So we recorded in this little studio called Original Sound, did Green-Eyed Lady, and it still sounds good today.
Corbetta's organ solo in Green-Eyed Lady is regarded as a classic.
Playing the accordion for so many years, my left hand was not as good as it wanted to be, so I just started. I was doing these exercises, started playing these chords. So that's how the song came about, and I thought, hey, that's cool, you know?
Prior to the release of Green-Eyed Lady, there had been a name change.
When we signed our deal at Liberty Records, the legal department met with us and they said, you can't call yourself Chocolate Hair because it has racial overtones. Weber and I went up to Sugarloaf Mountain where he lived. We said, well, how about the name Sugarloaf? And they said, like the mountain in Brazil? We said, no, like the mountain in Colorado.
Non-stop touring gave Sugarloaf little time for songwriting, so they invited Robert Yazel from the band Beast to join on guitar and vocals, as much for his writing as for his playing. An edit of his Tongue in Cheek, a track on the second Sugarloaf album, Spaceship Earth, became a minor hit in 1971. Sugarloaf added more band members, including Bobby Pickett on vocals, and concentrated on touring. With yet a third drummer, Larry Ferris, also from The Beast, the core of Corbetta, Raymond, and Weber recorded I Got a Song for Brute Records in 1973.
I got a song to bring the sun up.
When this album didn't have a hit, Corbetta was spurned rather imperiously in trying to regain a recording deal. This resulted in an amusing song about the fickle music industry by Sugarloaf, Jerry Corbetta. After recording the new track with initial drummer Pollock back in the fold, it was apparent they had a smash hit.
A long distance, directory assistance, every corp 212, could say, hey, AMR, this is Mr. Rhythm and Blues.
In Don't Call Us, We'll Call You, the CBS Records phone number and a general White House number were spelled out, touchtone style, for the world.
He said hello and put me on hold.
What the kids would do, they'd record the touch tones and then they'd figure out the thing. I guess they were calling the White House saying, the Sugarloaf lives here.
I said, you got my number?
We get a letter and they said, why are you having people call this number? Who is Sugarloaf? And so we had to get lawyers and they filed the letter back and say, well, they just dialed an 800 number. It was just by luck they dialed your number. They said, well, you must cease and desist. They said, well, it's too late. The records are out there. We can't.
The dance-friendly Don't Call Us, We'll Call You peaked at number 9 on March 29, 1975. But Sugarloaf broke up by 1977. A mix of those band members and studio musicians helped Corbetta lay down his self-titled 1978 solo album on Warner Brothers, after which the players mostly dispersed to other pursuits. Life after Sugarloaf was artistically lucrative for Corbetta. He co-wrote the Grace Jones hit On Your Knees and the Peebo Bryson-Roberta Flack number You're Looking Like Love to Me. He also was asked to join the Four Seasons for their 20th anniversary tour and continued to write and perform as a full member for 4 years. He toured with the classic rock all-stars until retirement.